Professor R. V. Arkiddi from Computer Science and Engineering Department of WIT Solapur. Today, I will be focusing on problem solving on principal conjunctive normal form. So, we are going to see what are the different problems on PCNF. The learning outcome of today's lecture is you will be able to convert the given equation into principal conjunctive normal form. Let us, these are the just recap the max terms. Okay, for two variables there are four max terms. They are from set A or set B. Okay, that is P or Q, negation P or Q, P or negation Q, negation P or negation Q. Okay, and set B is the commutative of negation set A. So either set A or set B we need to consider. So whatever the max terms are there for two variables, they are only four. So in a PCNF, it will be a product of only at the max four max terms or one to all four max terms are possible. And we are going to identify which are those max terms from this set A. That is our objective of the today's session. Now, the first problem statement, okay, the problem statement is like that, write equivalent forms for the following formulas in which negations are applied to the variables only, obtain the principal conjunctive normal form, that is PCNF, of the following formula. The formula is given in such a way that negation into bracket P biconditional Q. Okay, let us see the solution. As we know that in a PCNF or in a normal form, we have only basic connectives like AND, OR and negation. Okay, AND, OR and negation. So in this particular formula, biconditional is there. So we need to remove this biconditional. We need to remove this biconditional by substituting an equivalent formula in a given equation. So let us say assume that this is equation number 1. And since we know that P biconditional Q is equal to, there is equivalent formula called as P conditional Q and Q conditional P. Okay, let us substitute this formula in the given equation number 1. So that equation number 1 now will become as negation into bracket. Okay, so it will be a negation of negation will go off. Okay, so it will be only P conditional Q. Okay, and Q conditional P. Okay, that P having negation was there. Okay, it will go off. Okay, so it is equation number 2. Use De Morgan's law in the equation number 2. Okay, so P conditional Q is equal to negation P or Q. Okay, once use this particular formula in equation number 2, so that it will become P conditional Q will become negation P or Q, and Q conditional P, this particular formula will become negation Q or P. Now, after that, use the commutative law. Okay, use the commutative law in equation number 3. That is what? Take P as a first variable and Q as a second variable. Okay, so that it will be negation P or Q, there is no change, and over here in the second term, it will be P or negation Q. Okay, so this is what the required PCNF, required principal conjunctive normal form for the equation or for the problem statement number 1. Let us go for the problem. Now, I'll put a question over here. Okay, if a formula is having tautology, does it have PCNF and PDNF both, or it has only PCNF or it has only PDNF, that you need to answer. Take a pause in this video over here and write down the answer. The answer is, okay, if a formula is having tautology, it will have only PDNF. Okay, it will not have a PCNF. So all the mean terms will be there in a given PDNF. Now let us focus on the example number 2. Okay, the example is, question is, write equivalent forms for the following formulas in which negations are applied to the variables only and obtain PCNF of the given formula. Okay, this is the second formula. Okay, the formula is negation into bracket P and Q. Now we have to, this looks like a very simple. Okay, if you take negation inside the bracket by using De Morgan's law, so it will become So let us assume that that is given equation is equation number 1, apply De Morgan's law in equation number 1. So this will become negation P or negation Q. Now, is it the required PCNF? Is it the required PCNF or is it the required PDNF? See, PDNF means what? It is a disjunction of mean terms. Okay, it is what? Disjunction of negation P or negation Q. So definitely it is a not a PDNF. Okay, so another question will arise whether it is a PCNF. Yes, of course it is a PCNF because it is a max term is there. Okay, max term is there. So it is a PCNF having only, it is a product of only one max term. Okay, this is the correct answer for the example number 2. Let us focus on the third example. Let us focus on the third example. Okay, the third example. Here, write equivalent forms of the following formulas in which negations are applied to the variables only. Obtain PCNF of the given formula. Same question is there, and the problem statement is formula is different. Okay, formula is now here the formula is different. Negation to bracket P conditional Q. Okay, as we know that to obtain normal forms, we need to remove conditional connective by substituting an equivalent formula by applying De Morgan's law. By applying De Morgan's law, okay, let us assume that this is equation number 1. Okay, apply De Morgan's law to P conditional Q. So that will become negation P or Q. Okay, so the formula will be equation number 1 will become negation into bracket negation P or Q. Say this is equation number 2. Okay, now next, this is equation number 2. Okay, so if you remove this negation, that will become P and Q. Okay, now is it the required PCNF? Okay, in a PCNF, what we do? We take conjunction of max terms. It is a conjunction of variables. So we need to add, we need to convert these variables P or Q, okay, that into max term. Okay, that can be converted. Okay, that can be converted. Okay, by using the formula P or F is equal to P and Q or F is equal to F. Okay, here we are going to substitute F is equal to Q and negation Q, and for the second variable Q, okay, we'll substitute P and negation P in equation number 3. So P or F and Q or F. Okay, this is equation number 3. In place of F, for the first term, we'll substitute Q and negation Q. Okay, so after substituting that, okay, this will become P or into bracket Q and negation Q, and Q or P and negation Q. So this is equation number 4. Now apply distributive law over here. Okay, apply distributive law to the equation number 4. That will become this term. Simplification of the first term will be P, two brackets will be there, two terms will be there, okay, that is P or Q and P or negation Q, and the second one is Q or P and Q or negation P. Now we have to use commutative law, okay, and adimbotent law over here, commutative law. So after using that commutative law and adimbotent law, what will happen? P or Q is repeated twice. Okay, so we know that P is equal to P. Okay, with that formula, so the one P or Q will be retained. Okay, so finally only three terms will be there. So this is the required. So this is the required PCNF. Okay, this is the required PCNF for the problem number 2. Okay. Now in this equation number 6, okay, we have used adimbotent law. Okay, we have used commutative law. What is commutative law? It was Q or negation P. Okay, it was Q or negation P that has converted into negation P or Q. And P or Q that was converted, or Q or P was converted into P or Q. Okay, that was the commutative law. And adimbotent law is what? P or Q, okay, the first term and the third term are identical. Okay, so we know that P and P is equal to P. So that's why this equation number 6 will become only three terms, okay, where P or Q and P or negation Q and negation P or Q. So this is the required PCNF for the given problem statement. So these are the references, and I hope you have understood now, and you will be able to solve, or you will be able to convert the given formulas into PCNF, into principal conjunctive normal form. Thank you. Thank you very much.